Now let us see how to pass props to this stateful component. So I already created a copy of this file. I'll just put a comment in here so that you can easily drag it out. Passing props to stateful component. So this is what we are doing now. Okay, so once I update this comment and go back to my code here. Okay, so let's open the todo app, and in here we have this component called alert, right? So let's pass some props to it. So when this alert component is being rendered, right, I'll pass some prop called say message, and I'll put a value as do you want to continue. Okay, or maybe something else. I'll just say at are you sure. I'm just passing in some value. Now this message is passed as props to the alert. Okay, so if I come back in here in this alert constructor, this constructor will receive the props. Okay, so once the constructor has access to the props, the rule is whenever you call the super, you have to pass in the props along with that so that the base class can get handled to this. Okay, this is how the props are passed from the derived class to the base class. Okay, and once you call this super with the props, this props will be stored within the instance of this alert class. So I'll save this out, and once I am in here now, I'll come back to this div, and instead of hard coding something, I'll grab it from this dot props dot message. Okay, so this message in here is actually connected to the message that you are passing in the alert. These are the things that is connected. Now this is available in this dot props because you call the super with the props, right? This is the line that is making this this dot props dot message thing work out. Now we have to go back to the code in the base class and fix this. Now the first thing I do is I'll go to the component class, and right within the constructor in here I'll store this props within the instance of the derived class. So this is the connection. The moment you store it in this dot props here, it will be automatically available right within this class. This is one more thing to do, right? So let's go back to this build stateful component. And now if you take a look at how this new object is created, we are not passing the props, right? So let's kind of pass the props as well. Okay, so this is how the props reaches the base class at this point in time. Now once I do this and I save this file and come back to the browser, you should see this message are you sure rendered within this div element here, right? So I'll save this and go back to the browser and do a refresh, and you can see the message on the screen, right? So this is the way you pass props to the component, or rather stateful component in this case.